No, I think that there will be reprisals. There's a significant development. I think President Trump overreached in this tactical event. But the reprisals will not necessarily be imminent, and they may not necessarily come directly through Iran. So there is going to be some uncertainty. I believe that volatility generally will subside. We're not going to be remaining at these elevated levels as markets and investors start to refocus again on the more underlying economic fundamentals.
The story for 2019 was very much the one of the trade war and how the United States geopolitically would negotiate its economic relationship with China and to a minor extent with Russia. As we look at the 2020 outlook from these early days of trade, to what extent do you think that narrative will come back, or are we going to be refocusing on the Middle East and the potential consequences of higher energy prices?
I think 2020 is going to be driven very much towards the elections of November. And I believe that President Trump will be driving the levers, be it economic levers, political levers, geopolitical levers, in order to ensure that he comes back into office and he reduces the risk of a U.S. recession, number one, eases or continues to ease the tensions with China from a trade point of view, so as it does not impact the U.S. Economy and, interestingly, volatility and sentiment in financial markets. And in terms of the Middle East, I think this came a little bit stronger than he probably expected. I would expect some intervention there, not only from the US, but also, interestingly, from Russia, which has remained particularly silent. And I think Putin's potential interest in this is critical because he has been an ally of Iran. But at the same time, I believe that Russia wants to come in from the cold. And it would be, I guess, in Russia's interest to take it easier there with the US and Saudi to keep
the price. I understand the motivation that you're spelling out, that Trump wants to get re-elected and he's putting in place a whole series of events so that he can be. But what are the chances of a misstep? Because if you look at the way markets have been reacting, there were some concerns out there about a geopolitical event that's come out of nowhere. But ultimately, the market is so confident about this risk on rally that there's a global recovery story playing out. What if we're wrong? What if there is a misstep and events in the Middle East spiral out of control beyond Trump's ability to manage them? What does that do to this global recovery story that investors are so keen on?
I think that's a very fair concern to have. Partly in terms of the impact from the markets, I believe that markets reacted in the way they did because there was a lot of complacency all the way towards year end. And any volatility, any uncertainty, wherever it came from, would have had that immediate impact. In terms of the risk widening out, if in my view, President Trump was not looking for a war in the region. That's why he sacked Bolton. So I don't believe that his strategy was to increase the uncertainty and the risk in the area. This came up as a tactical event. And yes, I agree with you that tactical events could spiral out of control and it could filter something different. But I'd have that as a relatively lower risk rather than a central case scenario.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.